Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. If you're a trackpad user like me, and most MacBook users are by default, then you probably know there's some special gestures you can use to control your Mac. But have you taken the time to learn what they are? It's pretty easy if you look in System Preferences. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. You can read more at MACMOST.com/Patreon. Join us and get exclusive content. So it's really easy to see what gestures are available in your trackpad. All you need to do is go to the Apple menu and then System Preferences and then Trackpad. And here you're going to see various categories at the top. Now these screens have all changed as trackpads have evolved and Macs have evolved through each operating system. So you're going to see different things if you're using an older system or trackpad. But the point and click and scroll and zoom categories are pretty basic. More gestures is where it gets interesting, as there's a bunch of extra stuff, some of which will be on by default. I've turned them all off here so we can go through them one by one. So let's start with swipe between pages. If I turn that on, I get the option to scroll left or right with two fingers, three fingers, or either two or three fingers. Now you always get these handy little previews over here that show you exactly what the gesture is like. So you can just basically follow along with what's going on here. And they'll change if you change the option here. So when I change it to three fingers, you're going to see a three finger preview there. So what does this do? Well, this works in some apps to scroll between pages. So for instance, let's go into Safari here. And I'm going to use two fingers and go from left to right. And you can see it basically goes back to the previous page and loads that in. It's the same as using the back button. So you could basically use the back button instead if you like. Under history, back is command and the left square bracket. Forward is command and the right square bracket. So you could basically use these two fingers on the trackpad to do it, these buttons, or the keyboard shortcut. Now it doesn't say anything here about Safari, so this must work in other apps, right? Well, it does, but it's pretty limited. For instance, I can go into preview. So you think it would work here, but it's not going to because I have to first turn off continuous scroll and go to single page. Once I do that, then I can actually use two fingers to go onto the next page or back to a previous page. Now you also have the ability to swipe between full screen apps, and you could do this with three or four fingers. Now it only mentions full screen apps here. So if we were to say go into pages here and make that a full screen app, I can use three fingers left to right to go back to the desktop and back to pages. But I could also do that for any desktop in Mission Control. So I'm going to activate Mission Control with Control up arrow to bring up desktops here. And you can see I've got the desktop and pages. I'm going to add another desktop. So I've got desktop one and desktop two. Now when I use three fingers to swipe, I can go to pages and continue on to the next desktop. So it really is basically Mission Control, next screen, and previous screen, not really swiping between full screen apps. So next we have the ability to swipe left from the right edge of the screen. So put my cursor all the way to the right edge of the screen and swipe left with two fingers. It's not going to work for me, I think, because I have multiple screens here. So this really isn't the full right side of my screen here. But it basically imitates clicking on the notification center icon at the upper right. Now we've got the ability to bring up Mission Control by swiping up with three fingers or up with four fingers. So three fingers up and it brings up Mission Control. And you could do the same thing with App Expose, which is swiping down with three fingers. And it basically shows you all the windows for the current app. You could change that to four fingers as well. I'm going to skip over here to show desktop because it's kind of the opposite of that. You select that and you spread with your thumb and three fingers out and it shows you the desktop. It gets rid of all the extra windows. So if I have a bunch of extra windows open here like this, I could use this to get rid of them, see files or something that are on my desktop, and then I could use the opposite gesture to bring everything back like it was before. Now the Mission Control, App Expose, and Show Desktop features are all part of Mission Control, and there are keyboard shortcuts for those. So for Mission Control, just Control, not Command, but Control, and up arrow brings up Mission Control. Down arrow will make it go away. Doing App Expose is Control and down arrow from here. And using the F11 key shows the desktop. Now these can be changed if you go in System Preferences to Keyboard and then you look under Shortcuts. Under Mission Control you see all the settings there for it. And there's also a setting there for Show Notification Center. So you can turn that on and have a shortcut for that as well. And I should point out that Show Desktop F11 here, it sometimes isn't set there. So you might want to check that if F11 is not working for you. Of course, you may also need to hold down the FN key on your keyboard to make the F11 key an actual F11 key and not something that controls volume. Also, under Launchpad and Dock, there is the ability to set a keyboard shortcut for Show Launchpad. By default, it's nothing. So you've got to actually activate it and then give it a shortcut in order to have a Launchpad keyboard shortcut. Here is the gesture. You can turn it on and it's pinch with thumb and three fingers. So basically the opposite of Show Desktop brings up Launchpad. So you have the ability to do that with a gesture. You could do that, of course, by clicking on Launchpad in the dock, and you also can set a keyboard shortcut. Now I should point out that you have some of this under mouse as well. You have to have a mouse connected. So I've connected an older Magic Mouse here, and you can see I've got point and click and more gestures. And some of the things like swipe between pages, full screen apps, and mission control can actually be set as gestures using the top surface of an Apple mouse. If you're using a third party mouse, it doesn't have the little trackpad surface on top of the mouse, which is one of the things that makes the Apple mouse so good. But if you install drivers from the company that makes your mouse, often there's a separate control here or sometimes a completely separate app that gives you some gestures you can use with the scroll wheel or various buttons on that mouse. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.